Live from the Streamline Mortgage Solutions Studio, it's Orlando's own Tom and Dan. Whoopee!
Hello, this is your Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan program. We hope that you will find our presentation precise, joke-heavy, and just right. Thanks.
Welcome to the Friday free show of A Mediocre Time.
Hey, it is Titty Friday.
All right, we're back to that?
Yeah, take them bras off.
I thought it was Let's Go.
It's Titty Sweat Friday.
It's Titty Sweat Friday. The ladies in the chat room were talking about how they don't like the heat. And I came to the hypothesis that the reason ladies don't like heat is namely because they got titties.
That's a lot to carry around up there.
Yeah, especially when it's hot outside, which might be one of the reasons why you don't see a lot of female lawn care professionals is because of titties. Gets in way of your weed eater.
Yeah. Also, the other crew members,
they're horrible people. They're vile.
Are they going to say some insulting things?
Yeah. I was mowing my lawn yesterday, and I've never gotten more waves from men driving through my neighborhood than
that's
when I was mowing my lawn.
Two of those were Tom and I. We she's doing it. Titties and fish.
Remember when Tiffany came out with that calendar? One of the pictures was her mowing a lawn.
Everything was spelled wrong. Everything was spelled wrong in the calendar. That's what I loved about the calendar.
Brendan O'Connor's here. How you doing, Brendan?
Oh, his camera's all fucked up.
I liked it.
No, you did not.
Nobody needs to see me.
No, they like.
Look at that outfit. Everyone needs to see you.
That is. I wish I liked that.
All of our guests come here dressed way better. Kyle Eagle yesterday, now Brendan.
I had 20 minutes to get. I woke up and I was like, oh, I have to be there at noon. Tracksuit it is.
Oh, man, I have to live your life.
It sounds like a better time.
It is a better time.
You look like a Russian mobster.
Oh, well, I don't want anyone to mess with me.
I like it.
Peaky Blinders.
Yeah, I like that a lot. That's got a Burberry vibe going.
Thanks.
Right? Is that a fashion house? What do you wear? In there, is that just
it's Amazon Basics?
Okay, that's that might as well be a fashion house of Amazon Basics.
Yeah, thank you. That should be my Vogue house.
Is that couture? That's couture.
If I add something to it, it will be
right. Is that what that means?
Well, like handmade,
you got to stitch it or something. Tom's flabbergasted because he likes to think of himself as the best dressed around here.
Oh, he's wearing a polo.
Yeah, you've ruffled some feathers, sir, without even knowing it.
Thank you, Brendan, for posting about our Airbnb. Oh, I appreciate that.
Thank you for putting us up there, like giving us an excuse to go to Sanford. We needed it. It was like a staff retreat.
I saw that you had fun.
You
kind like
of
the
fun?
Party.
Were you mowing the grass?
Did you mow the grass?
I don't know. People still made, like outside of college, still made the old liquor watermelon. Like the
yes, I tried to tell you that's probably what happened.
Wait, you made
when
a
you
liquor
camping.
Watermelon on a Tuesday night?
I did.
Wow. Again, better life.
And we tried to do s'mores, but we couldn't figure it out, and I had to use my lighter.
You were making s'mores with a lighter?
s'mores.
And then I was like, what if they have cameras in here, and we'll never be able to hang out with Tom and Dan again? They're going to be so mad.
The cameras are only in the bathroom.
It's a toilet camera.
What do I care about the kitchen?
We all walked around without pants on, just in case we were going to get broadcast somewhere.
My God.
It was great. Such a good trip. So cool that it's like so close to that, like downtown Sanford, but it's the cool part of downtown Sanford that I actually haven't encountered much, like West End. And
yeah, it is right there. I mean, right across the street, there's bars and all, you know,
it's
so
almost
Sanford,
closer than walking distance, whatever that
means.
Well, we met
you could fall into a bar almost.
Oh, yeah. You could if you wanted.
If you were tall.
Yeah.
I mean, I can't
real
do it.
Tall.
I mean, it'll take me a couple of egg rolls to get over there.
But if you're tall, and then you're just hitting the trash can. Yeah.
Jeez.
We met the handsome Irishman that used to own the house.
Oh yeah, oh, yeah. From Murphy's Arcade.
Yeah. 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 He was hitting on my man. They were they were peeing next to each other, and then he was like,
"Oh, I'd like to suck your man's dick. Really suck his dick.
I like your lucky charms."
Yeah.
And then they just said, "I
are you staying at the house? Are you?"
I feel like everybody that stays there runs into him, right?
Yeah. Well he's Murphy's Arcade is across the street.
Yeah. He loved it.
He used to live there.
He abandoned all work and just hung out with us. Didn't want to talk to anyone else. He was very focused on us.
I'm gonna hit on your man.
That episode of Bar Rescue just aired.
Oh, did it?
Yeah.
It was the latest episode of Bar Rescue, which is Murphy's Arcade, which is right across the street from the T&D house.
We did not get to go to the goth bar, though, so we're going to try to go back.
They have to come back. Give you an excuse to come back.
I want
to
go there,
Tuesdays.
Too.
Yeah, so
I haven't
cool.
been yet.
Mannequins.
Yeah.
Oh, let me plug our featured merch item of the week, our collab between Villain and Tom and Dan. It's the Villain Coffee, Tom and Dan bag of coffee, and you can buy that at tomanddan.com.
It's
in the merch
a whole
section.
Bean, correct? Or no?
Do we know? I need to get some so I could.
I need some too.
I'll get Eric.
Yeah, it
to
does
bring
say
some.
Coffee beans.
Yeah, and so and I've had Villain Coffee, a lot of it actually, and they do damn fine coffee.
I need a bean grinder. I feel like, I mean, that's cheap, right? It's just a grinder.
I mean,
you're too lazy to do that.
You're not going to do this. I'm going to advise you not to grind beans because, again, Sam is right, too lazy.
Can I just pour it in a cup and then hit the button and it grinds it to the bottom?
Yeah, but you're not
going to
do that.
I think I would if it was.
You don't even want to pour water into the pot. We've already had this conversation about coffee.
This is just like the Crunchwrap thing. You can't do it. You can't grind beans.
He doesn't like
do
to be told
wrap.
He can't do things.
Oh, I got a question for Brendan.
I got a question.
So
you're turning into people.
There is no stupid questions.
So we did.
God don't make no joke.
A 4th of July barbecue over at my house.
Uh-huh. It was nice. Thank you for having us.
And I have this theory. I've talked about this a lot where if you go over to a friend's house, and this is
don't
as a
poop.
Guest.
You
yeah.
cannot poop at their house.
Oh, no, I pooped at your house.
That's fine.
I pooped at your house.
Why are you pooping so much?
I got a bone to pick with that bathroom. That is that. Put a light switch on the entrance. Why? His bathroom. When you walk into his bathroom, the bathroom that you use that's adjacent to the pool, and when you're having 1,000 fucking pool parties.
The guest bathroom.
Yeah, so there's a bathroom there, and when you go into it, you have to open the door and walk to the, it's a long hallway bathroom.
Really?
You walk to the end and turn the light on, then walk all the way back, shit, then wipe, then walk all the way down, shut the light off, walk all the way out.
In
like,
the dark?
Put a fucking light switch at the front of it.
That is odd.
Well, my house is all mishmashed together,
I don't know which if I'm supposed to go in that door, if I'm not supposed to go in that door, because the one door is always, sometimes it's open, sometimes it's closed,
leave the light on during the party. Your problem solved.
Oh, it's my crazy wife. She turns off all the lights. I'll walk out my front door to get something in the car. I'll go to get back in the house. The door's locked.
I do that too. That'd be fair.
I'm like, it's daytime. I'm here. What the hell are you doing?
She's sending you messages. That's a smoke signal.
It's a habit. I'm sorry. I was like, stop locking the door every 5 seconds. Anyway, so I've got a theory about when I invite someone over to my house.
Uh-huh.
They got to bring something to the table, right? Okay, so, and...
I
brought my world-famous taco dip. I brought world-famous taco dip and fresh-boiled peanuts.
That's two things.
And I'm not talking...
48 hours, those suckers.
I'm not talking about just a dip or some booze or whatever. I'm talking about what you're good at or your profession. Right. I want more than just.
He wants you to
dip.
Work at his parties.
Well, not
what?
That.
What are you asking?
Well, what do you have to offer?
No, like what?
Like a pole dancer.
Well,
like,
you are a pole dancer, I want to see.
You better get on that pole.
not a full dance, but
give us a little taste.
At one point in the party,
shake your booty a little.
Just swing around the pole once. Just fucking.
Hold on.
And I'm like, oh, that was cool. You're bringing something.
Would you accept just bringing your pole and setting it up and taking it down at the end of the night and taking it home?
Wait, just some sort of tip of the cap to what you do for a living.
You know, it's like if
show me a little something.
I'll give you a for instance. Huh? If I knew Jerry the Snow Cone Man and I invited him to my 4th of July barbecue,
okay.
And if he didn't show up with a portable snow cone maker, I'd be like, you get the fuck out, Jerry.
Or at least...
Is that what you mean?
Pour something on top of ice.
This is getting out of control.
So
Tom's a workaholic and now he's trying to put push that on everybody else. No, he wants you to work and it's got to be a party.
Brendan, I didn't know. What would I have done?
I brought my world famous.
I got something.
I brought world famous taco dip, and I brought it in a disposable container.
But you're not known for it. Tom wants you to like.
And I brought boiled peanuts, which I am known for.
But Daniel, he unknowingly already did this because I have the. Okay, so for instance, Brendan, I'll get to Daniel in a second. But if I invite Brendan O'Connor to my pool party,
what do you expect him to bring?
In a merman costume.
Yeah, you better have a wig on. You better have a merman.
You know, like you got to dress
a rubber
ducky wrap. Like if you just show up in cargo shorts and one tank top, I'm gonna be mad because I'm like, well, I want you to be like a little more flamboyant.
Have Elton John glasses on or some shit.
I got you.
I saw you at the belly flop contest. Yes, that's how we wanted
it. Yeah, you know. That, right, and then I'm like, perfect. You've fulfilled your duty.
What about Samantha?
Yeah.
Well, Samantha could do a couple things.
Like what? Take notes?
Yeah, I mean, like mow the grass. You can mow the grass.
I'm just saying.
He doesn't have any grass. It's all dirt.
You know, American flag bikini.
I'm not known for any of that.
Well, no.
Well, I mean, you're not known for an American flag bikini.
Yeah. You got certain attributes that we've
talked
about.
You got a big brain, Samantha. Your big brain.
Yeah. And then if, like, you just, you know, a little, not, I'm not asking you to wear a slingshot, but, you know.
All I hear is an HR complaint. That's what I'm hearing.
And this leads me to my complaint about Juan, our Twitch director. And
which, by the way, he hasn't been doing it. He retired.
And Tony Moonjet.
Yeah, Tony Moonjet. I'm going to go on a limb. I'm going to say Moonjet is your worst offender.
I didn't see him pull out his fancy camera once and take some really high caliber.
He's a photographer. He rocks at Sony. I didn't see the mirrorless Sony come on. I didn't see any photos getting snapped.
You're trying to direct a whole after party special.
No,
anytime you have people over, you want it to be a variety show at your pool.
No, he sets high standards, and if you come to his party, he wants you to bring your A game. This is not bullshit. This is not amateur hour. This is not a fucking practice.
If you're
this is real life, and we only get a few parties. So if you're coming to a Tom Van party, bring your A game, motherfucker. Get the fuck down the highway.
RuPaul's best friend race. Yeah. I want you to do something.
Yeah, I mean, we're not just showing up to hang out. The end of the world is coming, so you bring your A game. Moonjet, bring your camera.
If you're too much for a party.
If you're a professional photographer, I'm just saying, pull the DSLR a couple times and take some candids of my kids.
They're not there to impress each other.
Don't say take candids of my kids
No. And then you send me a black and white photo of my kids jumping in the pool.
If he said tastefuls of my kids.
Or some special moments of me like throwing my kids and then you're like, look at this black and white of you throwing your kids.
You're
like,
going to have to make party invitations and put it on the invitations next time. And say,
bring your A game.
Do your thing. Whatever your thing is.
Do your thing.
Is that what we're saying? Do your thing.
I want Juan cooking me up some stuff.
Yeah, he didn't even touch the tongs. Not even one time, but he sure ate the sausage, I'll tell you that. Oh. And Moonjet, I'm looking at you, Moonjet. You were a sausage pig.
You ate all
the sausages, Moonjet.
Or Juan could have fixed my internet.
Do you just cook sausage? All I ever hear about is
snack
the sausage.
I don't know. I'm an idiot.
I just want to know what's on the menu.
So I'll explain what me and Daniel do. Like, because at my pool parties...
I brought taco dip. I brought boiled peanuts. I put one tray of boiled peanuts outside. I put one tray of boiled peanuts inside.
Oh.
The ladies love the taco dip. I brought two different types of tortilla chips. I brought triangles. I brought rounds. I had everything.
All they want is a t-shirt that says the ladies love the taco dip.
They do.
So when me and when Daniel comes over to my pool parties, we rarely speak. we don't talk to each other.
I don't need to.
Because we talk to each other hours and hours a day. Yeah.
Look at each other. You send each other knowing looks across the water.
I don't even need to do that. It's on autopilot.
Yeah, I did this at 4th of July pool party. I'll get, like Daniel's in the pool. I took my shirt off. Get in the pool too.
Yeah.
And then I'll do 15 minutes of the Tom and Dan show with Daniel loud enough so people can hear it.
Yeah.
They want to listen to that. That's all we do. And we do it.
We give them an impromptu up to Tom and Dan Live.
A 15-minute segment.
And trust me when I tell you, as soon as we start talking, everybody's turning around like fucking E.F. Hutton's there.
I'm just saying.
Everybody. They're like, wow, that's so funny. Why am I laughing?
We bring what we do to the table, and everybody else
we never not bring what we do to the table.
Anyway, so speaking of the 4th of July party, I got more fireworks than I ever did, ever have before. Through Pyro Spot, no, thanks to
your buddy,
Craig from Pyro Spot.
We're live on Twitch. Hey, Twitch.
I did not do that.
I know.
We're back,
like,
everybody.
There's half a burrito in here.
Yeah.
This is weird.
Hold on. Are all the lights on? They are, but hold on. Hey, Twitch. We're glad to be back with you guys. I got to do one more.
We lost power for how long?
About 30 minutes.
Yeah.
First time. Enough. And they're all still there.
Elgato Control Center.
And we have a special segment to tack onto the show.
Yeah. So Daniel, luckily, is like, hey, let's just pull out the mobile equipment and just start doing it.
Get a little something done. Okay, you ready? Let me just make sure I got a good level.
Always.
Check, check. Hey, hey. All right. I'll bring us back.
Yeah.
Here we go. We'll be coming out of a song. Welcome back to a mediocre time. I was going to say a corporate time because now we're back with power. That was weird, right? How many years? Like 6-7 years of doing this in the new studio and we've never lost power because...
For that long.
I have backup batteries in here that failed me. They failed me good.
They lasted for about a minute.
Yeah.
Or a minute and a half.
I got to get a drink. Keep talking.
Long enough to save everything.
We almost, luckily, Daniel was just pull out the mobile equipment and record somewhere over here. But weird. I don't know. They didn't say why that happened, right?
Nope.
No reports. They
won't tell you. They're like, oh, Frank hit the wrong button.
is that true? Like, they won't tell you because, like, let's say there's like a... Because there are people, let's say there's like a locksmith store and the guy was out there fixing something. I don't know why I picked locksmith, but he's out in the front of his store, like digging, like you, let's say it's Tom working at the locksmith store and he's digging and he hits a wire and the whole block goes down. If they're like, yeah, it was a locksmith guy. And then you drive up there and you're like, fuck you, locksmith, right? Like, that's why they don't want to tell you that. Yeah. Because there was a part of me that, like, when I would see like car accidents or when a power outage, I'd be like, or you know, like when you're in traffic and you're like, car accident. Well, I hope they're dead. Anybody else do that? Probably not, right? I don't do it anymore. I don't do it. I'm saying I don't do it. But there was a time, I think, where I dabbled in the dark arts. Theo Vaughn.
Theo Vaughn.
He always uses the term dark arts.
If you text a number for all you see, and then it will find out where you are, and it'll give you an update. And generally, it gives you a reason. But this one didn't give us a reason.
All right.
Yeah, so I don't know.
And it's secret. Like at least the whole side of our street.
EMP for sure.
So, something.
I like that you went to EMP. You're like,
I like the nerd in you went EMP. I love that the nerd in you went straight to like...
Under siege.
And then
all the planets are in alignment right now.
And then you said this with all seriousness. You're like, oh, my phone still works, so it's not that. I'm
just like... Certainly not an EMP.
Look, he's trying to figure it out.
Well, I was like... Well,
it was a faulty EMP alarm.
But it's not that because that's a crazy thought. That's our first crazy...
I thought a listener finally is coming to get us and they cut the power in the phone lines.
That's another crazy thought. It is what it usually statistically most likely is.
The chat room seems to think that we were making fun of Juan and Moon Jet and the fact that they didn't bring anything to the party and that they were cutting our wires.
Yeah, I'm just fucking with them. So, Brendan, tell us what's going on locally on Bungalore. Of course, Brendan.
You cannot say Bungalower.
Bungalower. It's my mom.
Bungalore.
It's like it's making you throw
not
up.
Isn't it lower? Lower down the basket.
Yes, I'm bungalower. I can say
it. He has a hard time with R's.
Yeah. Bungalow.
His mouth stops working.
Bungalow.
Be in the bus on Fridays.
Don't say be in the bus. It's a be in the bus. It's going to sting me good, baby.
I'm allergic.
Bungalore and the bus on Friday.
Bungalore.
Yeah, lots is happening, man. I'm trying to think of what we're talking about tonight. The I guess the biggest story was the stampede at the 4th of July.
July 4th stampede.
Our buddy Dom from the Supervillains.
He was there, yeah.
And works at West End. He was there with his wife. And then he told us that...
I hope it was his
wife. Uh-oh. Is there a girl? Don't snitch.
The way you're saying it.
He told me not to say
it. The way you said it. You're like, I think it was his wife.
Hey, I was there, but don't say
it. It was his wife, right?
Very handy.
Why would you say like
I'm not sure. Well, because I get scared. That
no, but you did just say he was there with his wife and move on. You said he was there with his wife, and then you looked at me because he's gonna text me. He don't text you, and then I'll be like, "How come you guys are saying I wasn't there with my wife?" And I'm like, "I don't know. I don't know."
Well, no, I'm worried that it was like his wife's gonna be like, "Who the fuck were you there with?" Tom said you're there with your wife. Who was this mystery woman?
Because we did find out this week that people are snitching on what we say on the show to other people, i.e., Mike Smith.
No, oh my God!
Because at the end of the show, you're like, I didn't even want it. And I'm like, why would you say that?
Why would you say that?
He's a sensitive guy like me.
He told us that it was nuts, and people. He brought people inside his house because he lives right next door to down.
You're crazy. I'm not bringing people.
No, he was just like them in the lobby. Yeah.
I'm not hiding other people, man. I'm running for my door, and then I'm turning off the Ring doorbell
because they really thought it was an active shooter, and it turns out, allegedly, it was just some weirdos setting off fireworks behind a crowd of people.
Yeah, right. Making jokes because that stuff is scary, and anybody that was in that could have been like, really
got hurt.
Yeah.
At the
really point, injured.
Like when you see a group of people running at you and they're all yelling gun or something, like you're going to run.
I remember being 100%. Caught in a, because crowds, I remember being caught earlier in my life in a mosh pit scenario where I was getting mushed.
Yeah.
And I remember how, because you reach a point where,
Lots of people die that way.
Well, you don't have any way.
There's no control.
Nothing.
You can't get out.
You got nothing. And you're just being kind of moved around. And it's terrifying. It is really, really scary. It's as scary as drowning. It's just you're helpless.
It is drowning. It's drowning.
Yeah, drowning in people.
You suffocate yourself.
There were people getting trampled at the park.
The scary part is there were people just running and then just didn't know where to run. They were just running through bushes, just getting scratched.
I swear I heard in one of the videos we shared a lady say, "Leave the baby," and I need to go back.
Oh my God.
It was crazy.
Yeah, you do find out who's brave. Yeah.
There is one guy sitting in
that blue chair, and he's just like, and there's hundreds of people running around him. He's just holding it.
He's packing heat somewhere.
He's got a gun in his pocket. He's like, I've been waiting for this my whole life.
I am a hero.
I'm not retreating on July 4th.
Until the mob runs you over and starts trampling you. I should not have held my ground.
Now, the worst thing.
I should move with the flow of traffic.
Now, the worst thing you could do is if you grabbed your side and was like, "Ah, got me!"
If you start faking,
you're like, "Oh!"
Well, we had somebody make fun of it, but we were there.
We did the soccer game first. Me and Scotty, Scotty Campbell, my gay boyfriend.
You have a gay boyfriend?
Yeah, he's so gay. What? So we did the soccer game first. It was amazing. We lost, but then we hoofed it over.
That was a bad game.
We were awful.
Yeah, awful.
Just awful.
We set a scoring record, but not good.
4-2?
5-3.
Wasn't it?
I think it was.
It all was a blur.
Yeah, it was terrible.
We were drinking a lot.
That's fine. Yeah,
we got more thirsty the more we lost.
Easier to be trampled when you're drunk.
And so we made it all the way downtown, and it was like traffic was okay. But then we were supposed to hang out with our friends at Ford because they had like a spot to watch the fireworks. And we were going to give away. But we were like not into it, so we started to leave a little early, right at the time that there was that stampede, and like suddenly all the neighborhoods around, like even on our bikes, it was almost impassable because everybody was leaving at once. There was like 100,000 people, they say, at the park, and people were just freaking out because they thought it was an active shooter.
That's terrifying. It seems like the more and more groups of people are going to panic like this, because all it takes, if you think about it, is
we hear about it every day.
Yeah,
and like a group mentality.
When there's shootings every day.
Think about how hard not to panic every day. How people start the wave at sports games, right?
I've always wanted to start a wave.
Like it takes one person, then a group of that people, and then it starts.
But there's nothing worse than when it doesn't make it all the way around.
Oh, yeah, failure.
That's disappointing.
This one didn't make it all the way around. Like, yo, it was just the half.
Yeah, here. Yeah. But it's the same mentality. So like
snowballs.
You see a group running, you're turning around and running that way. You're like, what are you going to be like? I got to figure out what's going on in here. You're just like, oh, shit. I think your family, you're going to be like, I'm getting the fuck out of here.
Well, now, but I think I used to be. Like, if you'd see a couple people running, before, like, you would instantly go to shooter. Before, I'd be like, you know, I was a little curious, and what the hell's going on, you know?
Yeah, not
that way now.
No. And you can see it on the, there's a video that the city released from a security cam, because there's security cameras all around the park. Although, I think, like, three of them work out of the 20. This one worked, and you can see.
Oh, they're doing the old,
shot.
Just the shell of the camera.
Yeah.
Put an LED on
and
it.
It's like, yeah. Because somebody killed a bunch of ducks there once, and like a couple of years ago.
Yeah.
Like, they took out a stanchion, and they, like, killed ducks around the park.
Oh, my God.
And they didn't get them on any of the cameras, because none of the cameras were working. Oh,
the one time.
Yeah, check the cameras for the duck murder.
Oh, okay. We can't. Or, like, that guy.
Buy
that,
new
like,
ducks, then.
He took a cooler, and he was stealing swan babies. It didn't work for that.
The problem
swan
with that
babies.
Is that the person in charge of those cameras, he fixed them for the first 100 times, and it's just filming homeless people walk around.
It's just filming some guy shitting.
And then I'm shitting. And then at one point, he's like, oh, shit, I was supposed to fix the cameras last week. I'll go fix them next week. Yeah. And then you go fix them. And then at one point, you just stop fixing them. And then the swans happen. You're like, oh, shit, I'm in trouble.
I wonder if that camera's working.
If we could probably get that footage, because it's public domain, it'd be really funny to do like a People of Lake Eola like reality show, and it's just spliced together from the security.
But we do voices. We do voices for every character.
Yeah.
So hey, what are you doing over there? Yeah, I'm just taking a shit. I'm shitting on your house.
I thought it was great. I'm like writing it down.
I can do better than that if we have actual footage, I promise you.
All right, done. It's gonna happen.
All right, I'll voice I'll be all the homeless people. I'll do all the voices for
them. But it's also, it kind of compounds this like problem, like this perception that downtown isn't safe right now too. And that's something that the city and
is
the
that a
CRA
thing?
Is really, oh yeah, because there's shootings all the time downtown. Well, not all the time, but on a regular basis that it's enough that people are like, I don't want to go downtown.
I wonder if, okay, how would you combat this problem or this fear? Because think about all the crowded outdoor festivals and what happened at, is it Astroland? Astroworld? Where, people die like this all the time. You get crushed and trampled and die. Yeah. And
there's been other concerts after that, too, where like a speaker has blown and people think it's
a shooter,
an explosive, and then they've all been like trampled.
And then so now
it is scary. I do get nervous now going to outside concerts.
Because as a promoter, like now I bet your insurance company is going to be like, you're going to have to get extra insurance just in case like the crowd you have starts panicking and tramples people, or you know, because like in a normal scenario, the insurance company's like, all right, what's the probability of someone dying at this concert? Like, you got heat exhaustion, you got overdose, you got like the
UFOs.
Standards.
Yeah, like weird.
But now getting trampled because someone screams shooter or they hear something and then the panic starts and stuff, that seemingly is way higher than it was before. And then now it's like, are you going to be able to have a certain amount of group of people together? Are you
it's
always going to
stopping you know? Them? Like they're putting out this, the CRA has this new grant program right now where if you want to have, if you have an event with under, I think it's like 5,000 people, you can get $10,000 from the CRA to have your event downtown. But if it's over a certain amount, you can get up to $50,000 because they're trying to incentivize more people to do large scale events downtown, which is a little bit weird because they're also putting in these things about like
noise ordinances and no
outdoor speakers. Right. And they're like, Wall
so
Street.
What the fuck are we going
to
do?
It's like, we want you to bring a lot of people, but
and
they
do
have to
nothing.
Be really quiet.
It's like, we like money, but not fun.
Right. What about you?
That's how I figured it out. Because I was like, all
we
the
didn't
money.
Plan that. I promised you that Sam and I didn't have a button. No. All right, you ready to do the flash mob, Sam?
I'm like, these politicians are brilliant. All the money, no fun. That's the way to live. You just have a bunch of people quietly go and spend, give you money.
It's hard. There's an anxiety with everybody too about going into large crowds and going downtown. And so I don't know.
Well,
now it's less about
it.
the shooter and more about the
trample.
Getting trampled because people are panicked, because that is probably more statistically likely than the shooter.
I'd rather be shot than trampled.
But because it's everywhere.
Sorry,
So
I'm trying to make fun of it because it's so sad and crazy.
It's like my fault.
And then people get mad at me because they're like, you're insensitive. I'm like, no, I'm too sensitive. That's what you don't understand is I deflect. I'm too sensitive. We start talking about this shit, and I get sad.
Okay, yeah, it's my fault. I brought it as
topic. It's fine. You're good.
Well,
you're fine.
I'm definitely going to be an old man telling my sons, back in our day, we used to have stand in a field with everybody.
You'd put a girl on your shoulder, she'd show a titty.
We'd be nut to butt.
And there'd be boys with long hair playing rock music on the stage, and the cameraman would zero in on your mother. I'd have her on my shoulders, and she'd be juggling a titty up and down. They were painted.
That's how you were made in a field.
Her chest had airbrushed. It said Boner Garage. She was flapping her flapjacks up and down pendulously.
And they'd pack us in there, and the Hell's Angels were secure. Anyway, next story.
Okay, Art Sandwich Shop turned 50 years old this weekend. Very exciting.
I got a little confession to make. I had to text John Busdecker to remind him of the 50th anniversary. I said, hey, that sandwich shop that you did a piece on back in the day when you were doing your dumb little videos, it's turning 50 today. And he's like, oh, I should do something. So he put out like a nice thing. That was me.
He loves them.
I heard their sandwiches are great.
Is Art
great.
Still there?
They are, yeah. For 50 years they've been there.
What was I saying?
Art, no.
People, his descendants, I think it was his kids.
Son of Art.
Is his name Art?
I couldn't tell you. I think it's Bart.
I want it to be Art. It's not. Like, I wanted to own her.
What if it's Giovanni?
Not as good to me.
Okay.
Well,
I don't know why I went Giovanni.
It was good.
You own Cactus Bombs, your name has to be Bomb.
I'm the manager. Hi, my name is Raheem.
That was his name,
by the way. It was Raheem.
How do I remember that? It doesn't matter.
And you called him Cactus Kareem.
I just want the people that work at Jersey Mike's to be named Mike. It's a stupid thing, but it makes it better if it's Art Sandwich Shop and the guy's standing there.
I'm Barry.
And he's like, my name's Art. I'm like, yes, this is Matt.
I'm in the right spot.
Yeah. Anyway, sorry.
Those sandwiches, they put out like the cheesesteaks.
Ah, that's what they're known for is the cheesesteaks.
And then they put the banana peppers on the top. Yeah, it looks really good. And it's the chopped up.
They shaved a couple quarters off of it. You know, I'm sure the ROI on cheesesteaks is not high. So it's not like you're getting a twofer or anything there this weekend. But it's a little bit cheaper for a cheesesteak this weekend.
But just go and pay full price and celebrate the fact that they've been local for 50 years.
And everybody talks about
they should not be giving us a break on price.
I agree. We're just there to support. Yeah. Go support a local business. I think we kind of want to do like a carrot mob or a cash mob. Have you heard of those? Everybody brings like $10 and the whole mission is to spend the $10.
I've never heard of this.
I'm not doing it.
It's some sort of fun I've never heard of.
It's like a hippie thing. It's actually from the 60s. It's based off of carrot mobbing where people would go in like and help people harvest their crops, you know? But then they changed it to cash mobs and it's everybody comes with $20, $10, and your mission is to spend that money.
Let's do a Tom and Dan cash mob. Come to our tent and spend their full 20 with Eric.
Make
us rich.
I like this. Yeah. Come with your money and buy stuff from us.
Until you're out of money. This is brilliant.
Yeah. Let's do this at a cafe
convention.
You can't
do it for yourself. You got to do it for other people.
What?
Well, you do it for me, I'll do it for you.
And then we'll switch. We'll give each other the money.
Oh, you know what we got to do? We have to put out there, like, all right, our merch. We're selling our merch for less because of economic times.
Oh,
gas
do the
prices.
Steve White. Yeah, do the poor thing.
And then the news starts. You get
we'll be on Fox and Friends.
$300,000 worth of publicity.
DeSantis is coming here. He's like, these two patriots lowered their prices. We're like, we're goddamn right we did.
Exactly.
Is that what you want? I can do that.
Yeah.
I can do that.
Write that down, Sam. Yeah, okay. Lower prices to get news media.
Have you got a Google?
Lower prices to get meat.
By the way, Steve White did not do that on purpose, by the way, because I just have to preface that because I know Steve. He's the nicest man in the world. But I thought it was funny. Like I was going to call him like, great. A business move.
No, he just did it because he's nice.
No, I know. 100%. Yeah, it's authentic. Anyway.
But you're always counting his dollars. Yeah.
No, well, yeah, it works, but the reason we did it is legitimate, and it happened to work.
Here's the thing
well
about Steve that you'd have to know is that guy would have to, like, literally
He's given us so much free stuff over the years.
Yeah.
We'd be paying him back until we die.
Yeah. He's given more free than I've ever
seen. To charity, to events, any real radio event we did, any Tom and Dan event.
Nicest guy in the world.
Yeah, he really is.
It was awesome marketing that he got. Anyway. So that's all it's about. You know, I think every day I'm like, how can we do something that the news media says, like, look at Tom and Dan do this. And we're like, yeah. So and then, get you publicity.
I like that.
Yeah.
I hear what you're saying.
Yeah, but it's hard to
don't
come
write
up
a
with
book. That doesn't work.
It's gotta be for dumb people.
Don't do a documentary either.
No.
Nobody cares about books or documentaries.
No.
But if you get on TikTok and pretend to be your grandma, you do a funny dance.
Did you see
that TikTok of the guy that came down here on vacation and rode the sun rail?
Mm-mm.
No, we just shared it on Bungalow. His name's Jadeo or Jed. He's so funny. He's stoic. I don't know if he's autistic. He's on the spectrum or something.
Okay.
But very straight delivery. He's very excited to get on Sunrail, and he takes it to Advent Health because he read the write-up in Playground Magazine saying that it's the center of culture in Orlando. And he gets off, and he's like, oh, it's a hospital. This is so boring.
What?
And he walks around, and the write-up says to go to Orlando Science Center, so he makes his way walking over from Advent Health to the Science Center, sweaty. And he was like, I just kind of went in for the photo op and left because it's just me as an adult and a bunch of kids, and I felt weird,
yeah,
so I left.
Yeah.
It's so funny.
I'll check that out.
Yeah, go check that out.
Our mass transit system is horrible.
Oh, we don't have one.
No one, like, once
it's not that bad. I we took it.
Brendan, where can you go?
You can't go anywhere.
Winter Park.
It's closed at night. Park. It's closed on the weekends.
Yeah. You can go to Winter Park, but that's me and my wife, every year for Christmas, she's like, let's do the annual Christmas Winter Park Sunrail ride. We go to
what? That's a thing.
Yes, we.
How come we've never heard of this?
We go look at the
because
tree.
It's embarrassing.
You guys have so many embarrassing traditions.
And we get it. We ride.
I want to do this.
The Sunrail and the kids.
Do you wear Santa hats?
No, my wife does.
Santa underwear.
And then we go to Winter Park, and the kids run around in the field, look at some lights or whatever. And then I do say, aren't you too old for this? Like my sons, I'm like, you're running in a
do
field.
They like, it?
Like we took a train to a field.
Isn't that what cowboys used to do? Because there was nothing to do.
Is this the one when they have the light up, like the stained glass windows are lit up?
They just have all the Christmas lights in the big field. We don't even go for the lighting of the Christmas tree because Christmas is like, too many people get COVID.
Can't go to that. Too many people get COVID. Get trampled. Active shooter.
Anyway,
we're gonna ride the sun around with Santa hats.
But then
why do you hate your kids so much? You want them to get trampled?
But where else are you gonna go? Like this, next stop, John Young Parkway. What the fuck is this?
I'm gonna
get out of John Young Parkway.
Oh, we can get off at
3rd Street.
Oh, boys, let's get off here and look. There's a Rocco English billboard. Wow,
but
a Rocco English billboard.
You go to the zoo. They have the choo-choo to the zoo service now. You can go to Sanford and go to the zoo.
And then ride their mini train.
Yeah, their little trolley.
But how close does it let you off?
Right into the lion cage.
You get right in there.
Does it let you off downtown Sanford?
No, it lets you off just outside of downtown. You
at
hop
the biker
on a trolley,
bars?
Then you take the trolley
outside of the zoo.
That zoo is far as shit, Brendan. The zoo is like
let you out.
It's around the lake.
Okay, by
like near the boat. The boat ramp.
By the zoo, there's a biker bars. It lets you off near the biker bars. Yeah. A bunch of old ladies, with saggy titties, and bikers hanging out.
I want to get out of the train and then see where I'm going. Yeah, see like the location.
No,
I'm like, just walk
hop
right
on
into
the
it.
Fun trolley. Do the trolley ride, then go feed a giraffe.
But then you're waiting for the
trolley.
With your butt?
I fed a giraffe at the Sanford Zoo. That giraffe had to stop smoking to eat the leaf I had.
I can just see like, oh, yay.
He's like, hey, there's humans here. Put your butt out.
Yeah, all right. What you got, romaine? All right.
Those are tough ass Sanford giraffes.
DeLand? We did the DeLand thing where you could go biking on trails over in DeLand?
Yeah, of course you can. There's nothing there.
You can bike anywhere.
It's
it stinks.
It's a berry.
A million
berries.
square foot of woods.
Go hiking.
Hey, you can walk in there. You can bike in there. You can do whatever you want.
You can die in there.
Yeah, I mean, choose your own adventure.
Does it let you out in like because downtown DeLand is super nice.
It was DeBerry. I made a mistake.
DeBerry. You got that mixed up?
I did.
Oh my God, DeBerry is nothing but car washes and diners.
The post. It's such a small
Swampy's
town.
Grill.
The post office. They're like, that's Main Street, USA. So the post office and a diner.
And a swimming hole. You can't swim in anymore. It was really. They had a cute little spring there, but you can't swim there anymore.
Why not? Why can't you swim there?
Bacteria.
They're always saying that. I don't even know what that means. We got bacteria because we don't even run an air filter in our AC.
I wish I had known that before I came.
You know the best part about not running a filter in your AC? You never have to replace it. Why do you even need that?
Also, DeBerry, you're just a little bit better than Deltona. Doesn't say that.
Some would say that you might even be Deltona and not even know it.
Yeah.
I think DeBerry is Deltona. They don't even know that they've been consumed.
Named after a Deltona rapper.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't know that. All right. Next story.
It's not true.
Yeah, that's true.
That's why we don't know it. Did you see that Airbnb's giving out money? I almost didn't want to tell you about this in case you got mad because you kind of missed out.
No, we could stop ours and start it again.
Okay.
To take advantage of a loophole.
They have this, it's that OMG collection of like weird Airbnbs, like things that are shaped like UFOs or your
a potato.
Potato. There is that.
There is.
Yeah.
I know.
Yeah. Did you read it?
Or like that boat.
No, I haven't read it yet.
Like that houseboat in Sanford.
I'm just familiar with the potato.
They have tree house. There's a lot of stuff like this going on. Like the tiny house, something weird.
They do really well for Airbnb, right? So they have a fund now. It's called the OMG Fund. And it's $10 million they're going to give out to like a few homes to help fund these new weird homes to be built. And it could be anything, anything you want, anything your weird mind dreams up.
Well,
they want to build it.
Now, that sounds like a lot of money, but...
It'll go quick.
Yeah.
If you're building something from scratch. But what we're talking about is like a studio, like apartment that's in the shape of a potato. Like it wouldn't be... It doesn't have... Like you're not building a 2-2 bungalow.
You're right. Yeah, you're building a tree house or some sort of
a grain silo into a
What about a jumbo dog house?
Excellent.
Where it looks like a dog house, but you sleep like it's got a big dish.
But you
got
to turn it up a little bit because it's like, how are you going to get that million
bucks? You shit outside. Pee outside.
Oh, I got the perfect thing. So
you chain yourself up.
You chain yourself up. People abuse you and leave you outside in the sun.
Have you seen those puppies? Have you met the people that dress up like puppies?
The furry type people?
No, it's like leather instead of like. Oh, yeah.
I have not.
They don't talk. They just go, rrr, like if you see them at the park.
How do they communicate what they want to happen or not to happen?
They bark and point and stuff.
So you could poke their ass a couple times and then you have to figure out what their language
is. But they might try to smell your butt.
Or will they bite you?
So
maybe.
Do you guys
I like that Tom's trying to push past
I was like, force your way through the puppy talk.
Back to potato.
Now you know.
Have you seen I saw this on TikTok or social media where there are people that know when like they're tapped into like government auctions and then like counties and state governments and county whatever, they'll auction off stuff.
I want a Crown Vic.
I'm on an auction list. You can get Altamont Springs and stuff.
They'll do
I want a Crown Vic and night vision goggles.
Besides from things, they'll do property and so some guy bought a water tower for like $800 or something like that.
Those fire stations up on the stilts, national parks,
and then like certain small parcels of land that the county use, and they'll auction it off, and you can get it for cheaper. Like I own this square, like for $11. But so imagine an Airbnb in a water tower.
Yeah, awesome.
Follow me here. So you buy the water tower.
You'll
put a cage.
You need a lot of insurance on that thing.
Put in some windows.
Imagine
coming home drunk from Weston and you got to climb up a fucking water tower. That'd be awesome.
Well, you'd go through the stairs. You'd have to make something. It couldn't be an exterior ladder. That'd be too dangerous. But it's no different
than money for stairs.
It's no different than like a lighthouse, right?
Put in an elevator.
It's kind of like a lighthouse.
An elevator? No, it's insane.
Get $1 million.
I tell you, like,
how about a pulley system? Can we get a pulley?
You know, you're just.
It's gotta, I mean, you're going to have to put a chungus bucket in there.
A spotlight up on the top in a bed right in the middle, and the rest is just empty.
It's got the cage.
Makes it look like you're being videoed.
Yeah.
Or like a science experiment or something.
It is a straight ladder, like 150 feet, but it's got the cage around it. So if you fall, you'll just be ricocheting back and forth.
You just bounce your legs broken.
You're like, hang.
But I mean, I don't think you'd fall because you stick
your arms
out.
Your groin will hook, and it will neuter you.
Yeah.
What is happening?
You'll be hanging by your groin. You'll be like, oh!
Your limbs will get caught up in the cage.
You'll be mangled for sure.
But, I mean, I don't think you'd fall to your death.
No, yeah, you'll live. You'll live.
But
it's like the ski lift at Blizzard Beach. My daughter, she'll live when she flies, when she slips off.
And, oh,
but
good.
She'll be paralyzed good.
But imagine you, just like a bed and a couch and a living room.
It's
got
to be a water bed, though.
And,
and you can do projections on the side of the
crazy ones, though.
Yeah.
Like Clockwork Orange type shit. You know, like.
I wonder how hot those things get.
How are you going to air condition that thing?
At night, they're quite pleasant.
In the top.
One fan. Wood ceiling
just
fan.
Just get a split in there. It'll be fine.
Yeah, one mini split.
Yeah, a mini split will be fine.
You put some carpet or whatever. Who is anybody you've ever known been inside a water tower? I've never even heard of anybody I've met. It's like, I've been inside of the Altamont Water Tower.
I've never even climbed to the top of one. I've been to one, but that's about it.
You're right, because that was a big thing in, like, 70s. You know, the whole... Yeah. You
climb a water tower and get a blowjob.
Yeah, blowjob
the
water
tower. What are you going to have to helicopter in the furniture? How are you going to get everything in there?
You have to cut a hole.
You have to 1-800-HUNKS.
You know, you're gonna carry it up the stairs.
You pull it up through the hole in the bottom. There's some. You get a pulley system to get it.
Oh, we got a pulley system for the furniture.
Okay, what you would do?
IKEA flat pack.
Yeah, you keep it flat packed, and you'd like pulley system all the furniture up there, and you'd build it inside there.
A lot of work.
It's a ton of work.
Yeah. I like work, so I think I can do this.
I'm out.
You have the budget to pay.
All the work we did to the AirTND in Sanford. This.
You know what? I would rather after the AirTND. And I'd rather be trampled than do this again.
How many repairs are you going to fix this weekend?
Your pillows at the AirTND, amazing.
Like thank you.
The ones you slept on. I thought you were talking about our decorative pillows.
Very cute, the decorative ones.
Yeah,
but
yeah.
The sleepy pillows.
Yeah.
The hyper gel.
Yeah.
Is that what they are?
Hyper cooling gel.
Yeah. I need you to write it down for me before I go.
Next to the bed, Brendan, it says, like, take a picture or text Tom and Dan. You got the number, right?
But I thought that was just for the bed.
Back of the
Where'd
thing?
You put it?
But that's just for the mattress. That's not for the...
No.
It's everything.
Everything is
mattress,
Maloof.
Mattress, frame, pillow.
Yeah. It's all Maloof brand.
Well, I'm dumb.
And that's then, fine.
Well, okay. 321-521-2327. If you text Tom and Dan bed to that, it'll give you all the information for every...
Oh, that's happening.
Even the sheets and all that stuff.
Yeah, everything. What do you want?
That's wonderful.
That's premium bamboo, buddy.
Pillows.
Yeah.
I want
you sleep naked?
Yeah,
me too.
I didn't believe in that that cooling technology.
I just had to look your guest straight in the face when I said yes.
I don't know. And I looked at your crotch when I said that, which is like, what the hell are we doing?
We know.
Any more stories, Brendan?
Yeah, he's got plenty. What the fuck's wrong with you?
Do you know what a capybara is?
Oh, yeah, capybara. That's that martial arts where you
that's capoeira.
Dance
fighting.
You do the spinning, and they play the drums.
Well, now I want capoeira capybara. That's the Brazilian
capybara. There's dippable tacos.
No, that's birria.
I'm close. I'm hitting all around.
I like everything you say.
I'm back and forth between a weird-looking mammal animal.
Yeah. It's a mini bear, right?
It's like a beaver without a tail. It's
that's my
largest rodent.
Come on.
Flat ass.
Yeah.
So
two legs button up against each other.
People eat these things, right? Like
I don't think so.
No?
I think they're like the friendliest animals. You'll see if your algorithm's right on TikTok, you'll see capybara just hanging out at zoos, and all of the animals in the animal kingdom love capybara. They don't mess
with
them.
He's the most popular
they
guy.
Sit on them. It's like this very chill the dude looking hamster, but it's like bigger than your dog.
Can you have them as a pet?
No, they're exotic. You don't want to do that.
Well, there's some of them have exotic pets. That's the one thing we haven't been able to do as a podcast that I think
an exotic pet.
Well, it would. I feel like it would cement us as being successful if we had like a white tiger.
Yes.
Oh, if he had like an eagle.
Why's it gotta be white?
A falcon.
I don't think those
are
hard
to get.
Are
there black tigers? I've never heard of black tigers, but I would have one if they were cooler than white tigers.
Getting big cats is hard nowadays.
What about an eagle or a falcon?
The falcon you can get.
What's that little,
I can catch one in my neighborhood.
What's that little bear that you see under a microscope? The little digital.
Water bear.
Yeah, water bear.
I'm a tardigrade. That's what they are, water bears.
Yeah.
I love them.
We need one of those.
How does it live in space?
No, they dehydrate. They dehydrate until they're just like a husk of themselves, and then as soon as they land and they're around water, they just inflate again like a sponge, and they come back to life.
And they're happy.
That is supernatural.
Do we know that they're happy, or we projected that personality onto them?
I'm assuming they're happy.
Well, they look happy, but I think that's a projection.
Because they're fat and have lots of legs.
Yeah, they look fun.
Figure out how they do that, right? Like, because it's still like a mystery, right? Like,
that's how we could travel to Mars without having to do anything. It's like the laziest form of space travel.
We need a snake or something in here. We need something.
No,
those fish are not cutting it anymore.
Yeah,
I'm pulling the tank out of here this week. I'm just going to push it out the door.
Oh, get some shrimp or something.
Yeah,
we
have
used to.
We need some.
They would
crab.
Eat all our fish, though.
Yeah, they're dickheads.
Fill it with monkey. What are they?
Let's fill it with real monkeys. No. Let's put two monkeys in our
fish. Let's get some seahorse.
Herpes monkeys from
It's trying to get out.
Yeah, yeah.
Like biting at the mesh of top. Yeah. We're like, get back in the water.
Blow some smoke in there to calm it down. All right.
They're like bees.
He's chilling out. Drop a Snickers in there.
Is that where we kids?
My God, it's gone crazy. Put some Snyder's of Hanover, but it likes the sour cream and onion. The pretzel pieces. Put the pretzel pieces in
don't
there.
Don't look at it in the face. Don't look at it in the face.
It likes carbs. Don't give it any meat.
Like, oh, dead. They're like, I can't flush it down the toilet. All right.
We learned that with the last one. Yeah, capybaras. You can go see the capybaras at Gatorland, apparently, and hang out with them.
No. I thought, hold on. Is it Gatorland or is it Capybaraland?
Well, they have other animals.
They shouldn't.
But they should.
Because it's called Gatorland.
But it should be gator adjacent. Like snakes, I'm fine with. Yeah. All reptiles.
But crocodile, I'll give you that.
You don't think they should have mammals?
They have an albino raccoon.
No.
Albino raccoons, that's fine. Because
you think so?
Because it's an oddity. Like, okay. You can have oddities, like albino, anything else, but a regular capybara, I feel like, is
What if it's a capybara that does capoeira while eating burrito?
Okay, we can do something.
What about a shark? Is that gator adjacent because it's known as a scary animal?
The gators of the ocean.
Yeah, they are the gators of the ocean. Ocean gators.
That might be a crocodile, actually.
Yeah, I'll accept a shark. Okay. Surprisingly
I thought you would.
Yeah.
That girl just got bit by, well, she was scalloping. She got bit by a shark.
No, really?
Yeah, over on the coast.
Did amputate her leg.
Yeah. Oh, no way. Andrea's dad just got back from scalloping with her stepmom.
Yeah, dangerous.
And they were like down, they were scalloping for days.
And that's an anomaly. People scallop all the time. Like, I wonder if it was like, what kind
the
of shark
was
it?
Dressed.
A bull shark?
I would, you know if I had a family member that went scalloping and they got nipped, I'm not saying losing the limb. I'm just saying nipped. I would be jealous because they would get all the sympathy.
I would.
I want to get nipped by a shark.
Yeah, I would too.
Just so I can tell people. And like, oh, what's that? I bit by a shark.
This is why we're in business together, because people were like, you're both crazy. And we're like, well, you know what? Fuck you. Yes, we are. And we both want to get bitten by sharks to get a little bit of sympathy.
Do people get tattoos that make it look like a shark bite?
I wouldn't.
I'm sure someone has.
I wouldn't.
That's stolen valor.
No.
You can't do that.
It says that a family member had to beat the shark to make it let go of the
girl. I beat the shark
this
morning.
They wanted that girl back.
What kind of shark was it?
They don't know. It says unknown type of shark, but it was around 9 feet long.
That's got to be like a bull shark, right?
Like they hate people.
I mean, I don't know anything about sharks other than I dove with them one time.
What's weird is, but like there's black tip reef sharks that we dove with, but they're around reefs and stuff like that. Sharks and stuff, but like the ones that always bite the surfers out, Cocoa Beach and New Smyrna or whatever, what kind of sharks are those?
Bull sharks?
Well, I think bull shark is the real.
Well, bull sharks go up in the rivers too, right?
I think they can. They can go in brackish water and stuff. Yeah. Like, you know, obviously we don't have great whites here, but in California you have to worry about that. But they're never really bothering people. You know, like it's not like the great whites you see, you know, killing people or biting people or even getting near people. And like,
well, that was happening last California week outside of Peru.
Yeah.
They had people in the water and it was like back to back fatalities with great whites.
Yeah.
Super sad.
Less fish for them to eat.
Yeah, they put that shit on Reddit. Don't put those videos, man, where you just see blood in the water. What the fuck's wrong with you? Why are you putting that on the internet?
It's sad and gross.
Should we say some nice things?
Yeah.
Sure.
Anything else, Brendan?
Do you want some events?
Yes. Over the weekend? I like it when you give us events and then Tom and I shit on the event. This is my favorite thing. We should make this part of his bit because now we have some regularity of you coming in where you give us the event and Tom and I will tell people why not to do it.
This is today, right? Can I talk about stuff tonight or tomorrow?
Yeah. We don't care.
Okay. There's time travel with shows sometimes.
I'm not sure. Yeah. Okay. Most people won't hear it. Yeah. Or be like, this happened 2 days ago.
There's a traveling, it's like a Harry Potter inspired cocktail experience, but it's adjacent because they don't want to get sued. So it's called the Boozy Cauldron Tavern. And it goes all over the country. They're taking over the Abbey this weekend. Oh. And I know it launches tonight. I think it's tomorrow, too.
Are you encouraged to dress and bring wand?
Yeah. And then there are people talk to you like they're wizards.
Huff and puff. And
yeah,
it's like role playing.
Snazzledazz. And
so
it's like LARPing with drinks.
Slytherin Snape. And what are they all named?
That happened to me once.
Harry Potter in the case of the case of the Alcazan, Bazabadab, whatever, all that garbage.
Yeah.
So it's a traveling themed bar that they put up or decorate and then like do this event.
Yeah, it's like an immersive wizarding cocktail experience called the Boozy Cauldron Tavern, a magical cocktail experience.
Okay.
How much do they decorate the Abbey?
Like, I don't know.
I hope it's one plastic cauldron.
I know, yeah. Because
I would be like, this fucking rules. I'd be like, thank you for giving it.
And a bunch 1%. Of nerds
and then it's like, what else do you want? You want a broom? I'll give you a broom.
It made me think. Did you see? We visited this MMA group that gets a full plate armor. Have you seen that?
Oh, the guys in town. And, we have their sticker on their door. They came in here. One of the guys, really annoying.
come on.
No, he was. He was. That's fine. He knows.
Yeah, I don't think he doesn't. I don't think he does, though.
Well, what is he going to do? Chop my ankles?
Every time I have a really annoying person is talking to me or around, I'm like, that person definitely doesn't know they're that annoying because they would stop talking.
He's talking about me.
No.
They're just excited to be around you guys. You're big stars.
No.
Stop.
Please. No, I like that. When they Dota, they're like, you're talented. You got me through a rough time. I'm like, yes, I did. but if they're talking,
they call me Dr. Rough Time.
But if they're talking about themselves and their political beliefs, I'm not interested.
No, here's my Venmo.
My wife just left me. And, oh, my God. Yeah, here it comes.
She should have done that before. Bless her patience. Bastille Bash is taking place in Audubon Park. So just up the street.
Oh, it is Bastille. I don't know what that is.
It's like Storming the Bastille.
Is this
annual
a French thing?
French inspired party over at Audubon Park.
Is it to commemorate Bastille Day?
Yes.
What is look up Bastille Day?
It's when they stormed the Bastille and someone.
My Uncle
got
Randy's
shot.
Gonna show up. He's like, I heard about storming. We're doing some storming right here.
I got on my water buffalo hat.
You know what? My wife Bastille's my heart. I love you, baby.
So what is there any sort of reenactments?
Yeah, kind of. There's a market where you can do wine and cheese pairings. There's a roving Maria Antoinette just sweating her way through the day at Audubon Park. You can take pictures with her on your wig.
Cool.
You can sign up for a 4-course Bordeaux tasting wine.
That's
tasting
a wine
dinner.
Deal.
There's a baguette fencing thing that happens all at Audubon Park by like Park Ave CD
fencing
and, yeah with baguettes and if it
that's
breaks
right.
You're out
that's cool.
Brendan,
Wes Anderson French Dispatch screening and a burlesque show.
Brendan, let me ask you this, have you been to a fancy wine tasting?
Yeah.
So
what do you think he's not?
No, I'm just fancy? Because I'm asking because just if you haven't, then maybe you wouldn't have ever seen this. But I saw Post Malone at some sort of fancy restaurant, and he had a
that's the juxtaposition I need in my life.
he had like a glass of wine. They poured.
Are you sure it was an Olive Garden? Because he's obsessed with Olive Garden.
Yeah, he loves Olive Garden.
It could have been a joke, but it didn't look like an Olive Garden. But he sips the wine, but he does that. He does this whole, like, first he swirls it and then he's sipping it and doing this.
Smell
whole,
the bouquet.
Lovely.
Fruity up front.
Because I'm like,
very dry finish.
You are stinking rich. So maybe you do know super fancy wine, but you...
No, he don't.
Post Malone.
He's a Bud Light guy. He says it.
Yeah,
I know.
Loves Bud Light.
He loves Bud Light. Yeah, yeah, which is one of the reasons why I like Post Malone. And he's just Post Malone.
And you look like Post Malone. I'm like, do you...
He also drinks red wine with a straw.
Yeah, he's just a guy. Yeah. He's just like, I am who I am,
but
whatever.
But he was obviously... I mean, he put this out on his own social media, so he was obviously showing people, like, I know the thing. I know the mouth thing. I know the swirl.
Maybe he's just fucking around.
Right.
It could be that. I don't know...
Is there a question in there somewhere?
You don't know Mr. Malone's sense of humor?
My question is, I've been to like a wine tasting or that kind of thing.
Bragging again.
And I pretend like I'm doing what Post Malone is doing.
Because you care what people think.
Well,
yes.
Well, because I don't want to be like, what, a chugging the wine?
Well, you're drinking out of your shoe.
Well, don't do that either.
So I'm like.
It's a happy medium there.
Scotty hates it. He thinks it's all made up.
Swirling and tasting. I'm like, it all tastes like wine.
It smells like grapes.
Yeah. I mean, there is some truth to what Scotty's saying because a lot of that, I believe, is the tradition of wine. I don't necessarily think you need to do all of those steps to taste it and be like, I know what this wine tastes like.
It's just about if it helps you enjoy it more, you know? Like if it helps you take a minute and like try to smell it and, hey, what does this smell like? Maybe there's some other notes in here that could make it more enjoyable through that process. Cool. If you'd rather just slam it back and not think about it, even better. Do whatever
you
need to
do. But then you're a vulgarian if you do that. This guy doesn't deserve to be.
Why do you care?
You would think that people are judging you if you just took it and they filled it up and you just slammed it back and go, give me one more shot there.
Someone brought a white trash.
That's the nature of the event you're at too, because it's like, those events are meant for you to slow down and immerse yourself in that experience. That's why they have it paired with a certain cheese.
I hate
from
pears. I hate immerse.
Smell the wine. Smells good. I don't know though. I can't tell you.
Your buddies at Rock Pit, they do the cheesecake and beer pairings, and it's the same kind of an impulse.
Because I like sweets, I like getting fucked up.
I've never tasted a bad beer, a bad wine.
Me neither.
I've never tasted something and been like, it's always been like,
I mean, like, even a skunky beer, this is why we're in business. Even a skunky beer, I'll taste it. I'll be like, well, that's skunky, but got to get fucked up. I was just like, whatever.
Did you have that mashed potato beer that the Hourglass Brewery guys came up with? I think they still have boxes of it somewhere. But
they still have it on tap.
Mashed potato
beer. Last time
beer.
We were there, they didn't.
Mashed potato beer.
Yeah.
I've got to try that.
They made a beer of Norm's body style.
He doesn't deserve
that. All right, one last story.
Two last stories.
This might be the right
one and a half.
Do you know Hanks? Have we talked about Hanks on this show before?
No, what's Hanks?
It's secret. It's a secret gay speakeasy. So I don't know.
Oh, dude, you and I need to go to Hanks.
Yeah.
No, I don't think
we and Lando,
you shouldn't go to Hanks.
Oh, is it a place you go to hook up?
Yeah.
Because we love, like, okay. I've said this before, and I think I've told you this before, but Tom and I used to go hide at Stonewall Bar.
Oh.
Because before Orlando City, it was the only place we could go, and we'd go to that back patio bar and just crush Bud Lights.
And they're cheap. Like, they free pour those liquor at Stonewall.
And the bartenders are so awesome. They're great. I love that bar, but that was our secret hideaway, and we need a new one.
This is different. So this is
this is more advanced.
This is on Edgewater, like North Edgewater, kind of near, like, George's Hideaway?
Yeah.
Yeah, so near there.
The tavern, George's Tavern, is that what it's called?
I can't remember. It's George's. I think it's George's.
So this is Hanks, and it's a secret gay speakeasy.
Kind of. They're having their 35th anniversary there. That's the only reason I bring it up.
Well done, Hanks.
But they've converted their back patio. It's like a labyrinth where people just go and like get handies and BJs.
Hold on. There's
there's a blowjob labyrinth.
Just
call me David Bowie. Yeah.
Instead of minotaurs, it's just lonely looking businessmen on their way home to work. Like, it's really sad. My buddy brought me there when I first moved here because he was like, "You got to see all these bars," and he brought me to bar.
And they got a blowjob labyrinth.
Yeah, it was kind of scary because it's like dark.
Is it a maze or is it different? Well,
it's fences. It's fences that they've. I'm gonna get in trouble. I feel like someone's gonna take my gay card or something.
Can they? I don't think they can because you are gay. You are the card.
Like they have free pool
beach
on
umbrellas
Mondays.
On the top. Like of the fence, so it's like it's enclosed, so it's almost like
a tunnel. Fucking brilliant,
all the way around. Yeah. Like it's a
it's
little
like a strip
scary.
Club when the back rooms where yeah. you walk down a room and then you yeah. see in the peripheral yeah. vision on the right. Like, yeah.
On the right, there's a businessman with no teeth, and on the left, there's like two guys. It's really weird.
Damn it, I'm mad. I
but
didn't know
it's
about
their
30
minute anniversary. Now you know.
Use your money for teeth, businessman.
Yeah, it's
why
a
do you have no teeth?
Because I give great blowjobs.
Well, you're not a good businessman.
$2 drinks all weekend.
Hell yeah.
That's good.
Yeah. But they don't let girls in.
Oh.
So you're going to have to get your pussy licked elsewhere.
I like that. I like that.
You like that.
What about non-gay men?
We'd be frowned upon, right?
I don't know. I'm sure there's some that don't identify as gay.
What?
It's not gay if they're sucking your dick.
That's my army.
Finally, somebody that gets it.
Finally. I told a couple straight guys that in my life.
Oh, my God. Please do a go-to show to Hanks.
I would do
I
it.
Won't be able to go. What but...
Okay, Scotty on Twitch. Is Scotty on Twitch and he's yelling at me right now? Are we okay?
I don't know.
Here's my honest answer, Sam, is I would do that, but I don't want them to think we're making fun of it. Yeah. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Because if it's a safe place where people go and they have fun and it's no harm,
I think you guys would have fun.
But I don't want them to think they were going there shitting on
I took John to Barcodes, which is kind of similar. It's just not as sad.
I've never been.
And you can hang out in the bar and you're fine. You can hang out in the bar. You can do the, they have a sex shop in there if you need to buy some poppers at Barcodes. Right.
We need pop. First, we'll just start with poppers.
Yeah.
I feel like you and I should just do poppers on the show.
Yeah.
They probably sell them at Fair Villa.
Yeah. Well, they sell them at Savoy, too. So there's a little vending machine.
And it relaxes you, right? It like,
Let's do a BDM show on poppers.
All right. It's a muscle relaxing.
I need that. My muscles are always so tight.
Right. Put my pants on.
They say millennials.
Oh my God, I'm the president.
Millennials are doing poppers, they say now.
What'd you guys do today on the show? Well, we decided to go to the secret gay club, but we did poppers and shit our pants.
Well, how loose can it make you? But I'm saying,
wide open, baby.
Looser than alcohol? Because of
alcohol tightens you up because it dehydrates you.
People, you'll do it. They used to do it in the 80s. You do it when you're dancing because it's a little euphoric and you get a rush.
Hold on.
But you also
take a popper, shake my titties around the dance floor.
It's like liquid incense or like keyboard cleaner.
It's straight up like paint remover.
Oh, that sounds awesome. And I'm twirling that new Beyonce single. Yeah. I don't take myself.
There's some statistic that
I love that song. I've been twirling to it all weekend.
Drunk drivers.
Release your anger. Release your feels.
Drunk drivers die less in drunk driving accidents because they're looser because they're drunk. Yeah. Like, that's a real thing. So alcohol loses you up a little bit. Like, you're flying out of a windshield.
It's
you
a different kind of loose. Yeah.
This is a little loose.
How much looser can you get?
You'll find out.
You get all loose and flying out your windshield.
We're all gonna do your loose
drunk driver again. Let's make that a dance.
It's the Bernie lead.
Fly out your windshield. Yeah. You get looser
you get
than
so
that.
So loose that you fly out your window and the car goes in your ass.
I want to do that.
They're like, "Where's the car? It's in my ass." I'm so loose. I swallowed my own crashed car.
Parallel parked it. Yeah, right here.
My God. But we're definitely doing poppers.
I'll be your gay Sherpa. You want
what
me
is
to
it?
Be
is
gay
it a pill?
On your first popper?
It's a liquid. It's a little bottle of liquid.
My God.
That you sniff.
And they all have funny names like jungle juice.
Oh, we'll call it gay ayahuasca.
Yeah,
we'll
you're basically it. Inhaling it.
You can be
it.
Our shaman.
Drink it.
No.
Brenda can be our shaman, and we'll pretend it's gay ayahuasca, and we'll do poppers.
And then we'll go dancing.
Tom, do not drink poppers,
what
please.
If you drink it?
Don't drink it.
Do not drink it.
Oh, open things you shouldn't open.
My throat.
Oh, my God. He's the world's biggest throat.
Don't do it.
Daddy Thick Neck.
Daddy Thick Neck.
Death by poppers. I don't like it. You can get it. I've tried it a couple times. You get, headaches.
I already have headaches.
Yeah.
And my wife always
had
a headache.
Good for you.
Yeah, but you get the headaches after. It's like the Mitch Hedberg joke. No. Like, who cares what happens at the end of the experience?
During it's great.
That's all I want. Yeah. I don't think about my repercussions of anything.
Can you take too much of it and get too loose?
Yeah.
You turn inside out.
Oh my God, help.
The upside down. You're like that thing with its face that opens.
Yeah. Demogorgon.
Yeah, yeah, that's your butt.
Almost on a nightly basis, I'm like, one more white claw. And then I tell myself as if, like, I'm like, okay, you deserve one more.
Do you know why I pulled back?
One too many.
Do you want to know why I pulled back? Because I would go to bed with one.
You know,
I would bring one to bed and bring one cold one. Because I'd be like, I'll finish this one, and this will be my nightcap.
Wow.
And then I'd wake up the next morning, and then there'd be a half-drinking one on the counter. I'm like, oh my God, you have a problem.
That's a sign.
Yeah.
And then it can't be that bad. My kids have strawberry toothpaste. Same thing. So
there you go. You're welcome.
That was
thank
a good
you, Brendan.
One.
Again, a bungalore.
No.
Bungalore.
Oh, man.
And the bus on Fridays on Real Radio. Yeah. You can also get the podcast and check out Bungalore.
And buy their book.
.com. Oh, yeah. 100 things to do in Orlando.
Thank you. John will yell at me if I don't bring that up.
Yeah, yeah. And it is a great book to have just because if you're looking for something to do, you know, go to page 68. They're like,
we have a copy.
Poppers at Savoy.
Yeah, it says go to Hank's and stick it through the fence. we have a
one drink minimum.
We have a copy at our Airbnb.
Oh,
we do, yeah.
For people.
Oh,
so when guests stay there, that
like
you didn't see it?
No, I didn't see it.
Somebody may have taken it. Do we have another copy?
I'll bring it.
Well, it's possible that somebody thought we left it there for like a handout or something. The name of the band is Kid Capici. Capici. The name of the song is Rob the Supermarket. It's fun. It's a fun little tune. We'll be back with more A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. Closing out a weird day, but a fun day. We'll be right back. Welcome back to A Mediocre Time with Tom and Dan. That is Keep for Cheap with Segway.
Real quick.
What are we doing here?
We're going to do a party meetup at Cafe Da Vinci July 29th. Little Stranger is playing. True Phonic is opening for them.
Yes.
It's a free show. We're all going to be out there. We'll be out there on 8:30 in the land July 29th. And then also... Eric will be at the Sanford Food Truck Fiesta this Sunday.
Yep.
So Brendan, real quick, because then we'll let you get out of here. Because it's been a weird day. We lost the power. We sat around in the dark.
I could stay with you all day.
Oh, well, thank
you. So here's, okay.
We love having you, man. Thanks for the time today. We appreciate it.
So we're talking gay bars, right? And I feel.
So gay.
So follow me with this.
Uh-huh.
I love gay bars because everybody likes to drink. Great drink specials.
They pour heavy.
They like to party.
Bartenders are usually really good. It's a stereotype, but it's a true stereotype. Sorry.
They got to work hard for us.
They do.
Bartenders are great.
They're usually the best bartenders. Fast.
Everybody's having fun.
No one's trying to fight.
No one's
if you
aggressive.
Are, they'll get you the fuck out of there.
That's on lesbian night.
Super. I was going to say that stereotypically, I don't know, like lesbians have to step their game up with their bars. They're not known
Faces
as the
Faces used to be
fun.
Pretty good on Lee Road.
They're all closing. That's actually an
Do you remember Faces?
Not to bring it down. Yeah, I don't. I've heard of
that
it.
That was a great bar.
Yeah.
I've been there a couple times and it closed down.
Gay men
There's
stereotypically.
There's like three lesbian bars left in the country.
Okay.
There's not many.
Seems like gay men are stereotypically more fun. I don't know. I'm just throwing it out there. I'm going to get a lot of hate. That's the stereotype. I'm ignorant. I don't know. It just I
As a gay
see,
man, thank you.
That's what I see on TV. Anyway, so I equated to this. One time... we went to Germany to visit friends years and years ago before
this
kids.
This is when you were into poo-poo stuff.
And we
what?
They both were in the military. They lived right across the street from the giant military base.
Uh-huh.
And we went there. We were hanging out. And then they were like, oh, let's go to this local bar. And we went to the local bar, and it was all military, like all military men, women, everybody's like people are dressed in like their military garb, some people not, but basically it was all military. And then they give military discounts and stuff, and then we were drinking with them, and then they were like, oh, like, you know, just put on my tab, I'll get the military discount. And I felt bad because I'm like, well, I'm not military.
Stolen Valor.
Stolen Valor. And I feel when I go to a gay bar.
When you and I would go to that bar, they would think we're a couple, wouldn't they?
No. I feel.
Well, we'd be kissing.
Like, if you going to a gay bar and taking advantage of that.
Stolen gay valor. That's what we're saying.
No, it's not for you. Yeah, I get what you're saying.
Because now I'm taking advantage of what you guys have built and your mentality.
And you're benefiting because it is it's a nicer experience for the most part.
I'm getting better drinks.
I'm benefiting on the drinks.
How is that looked at?
So
you're fine. We hate bridal showers, but anyway,
you know what? Yeah.
If I see one more bridal shower happen in a gay bar, it makes me so mad. And especially when we couldn't get married, and you see people having bridal showers
bridal
in a gay bar prior to
what was that?
I never thought about that.
So tasteless.
My wife did that.
I literally almost just screamed.
You just hear them. Arms in the air.
My wife may have done that too. I'll have to confirm.
But it was at the old Parliament House, and she went to see a show.
Yeah.
But it's similar things.
No, I think my wife straight up was eating pussy.
Listen, stolen gay valor. I'm telling you. Like, yeah. So am I wrong about feeling that? Because I feel like I shouldn't
be
getting all the perks.
I'm not going to tell you your feelings are wrong, Tom. What you're feeling, whatever. That's what you're feeling. Yeah,
that's
what
a really respectful way to say that.
But you're wrong.
You're
welcome.
Care, yeah.
It's okay. Like maybe back in the day when gay bars were the only places that gay people could go.
It was like, get in here, you're safe.
Yeah, because it was literally illegal.
Please lock the door.
Like, right, to be gay, like you could be gay and they'd have these, there were gay speakeasies.
Yeah, yeah.
Right?
You had to hide from society because society was horrible.
And then, but now everybody goes to gay bars, so it's fine. Yeah. You're fine. Just don't be like obnoxious and weird and say, you know, fag and stuff.
Oh my god. You know, if I had a nickel for every time this guy starts the mornings, he's does his stretches. I know.
Why
would I say that?
I have lots of strength, bro.
Why would you even tell me that?
Good morning.
Hey, you're going to be feeling good. You're going to be feeling good.
That polo says you say it, Tom.
No, it
happens.
It's turning red.
You're going to get real comfortable.
Oh, my God.
And it's going to slip.
Hey, you can come here, but don't say a horrible slur that only a horrible person would
I went to
scream out in a gay bar.
Yeah.
Why would you do that?
What's the password?
Is the pious word fall?
Did you University Club? Remember University Club?
I used to live there.
What?
Yeah.
It was a gay bar.
You didn't know that. You're gay.
Thomas, you didn't know.
I didn't know he was gay. You didn't know you're gay.
I had a very conservative.
Bring in your sons. They're actors. Give it up.
I had a very conservative lawyer friend who brought me there once. He wanted me to be his gay.
Oh, this is a bar.
Liberal
friend. I thought you were talking about the
apartment
complex.
No, University Club downtown. Like the,
No. I was talking about the apartment complex near UCLA.
Oh, no. It's like a private club for like rich judges.
Someone called us and told us about this. They worked on that place. Remember?
Yes.
God damn it.
No, you are right.
So it was like,
I know
it was
exactly.
Like two stories.
Yes.
It was right by the library, but now it's where Modera is and the new shoe store, like Michael Jordan, so like that.
Yeah,
that's
that luxury kicks place.
But they now have like a more state-of-the-art club in there. But he brought me there because he was trying to impress me because he wanted me to be his liberal gay friend, token liberal gay friend. And when we were, and I didn't know what it was.
Am I supposed to have one of those?
Yeah. He thought he did. And he was punching
the
code. There's a little punch keypad on the back. He brought me up, and I showed up after work from Orlando Weekly. I was wearing short fluorescent pink shorts,
a
denim shirt, and he was punching the code in, and he turns around and he looks at me and he goes, "Don't take this the wrong way. Just don't be so gay." And then he went in, and
oh
I was like,
God.
What is happening? And I went in, and it was like Republican Narnia, and it was all these old men. Like, they should have been wearing wigs, and they're all drinking beer out of their styrofoam cups and talking about, you know, IRAs, and everything was wood paneled, and talking
society,
about hippies. And,
weird.
Yeah, it was so weird. But I... You know, they were saying fag and stuff all the time. All these people are just throwing it around. Because they didn't know. Because I was an interloper. You know, they're.
It's weird that they.
Who invited this?
They were saying it like that.
Or not like at me. They were directing it at
me.
But it was almost
like
they were trying to test me to see if I was cool.
Right.
The question one of cool test. Are you a.
I know. And I had to go into like a special place of like, I'm just an alien.
visiting right now.
I mean, did they really have to ask? You had on tiny pink shorts. What do I want?
And I was giving the one guy a hand job.
That should have given it away.
Well, that's not gay.
Wow.
That's their secret handshake, though.
Sometimes when Tom is super stressed out, you know, I'll help him out when he's crunching the numbers.
Oh, and with this, that's another favorite thing about a gay bar is that they're like, hey, you guys like hand jobs. We'll make an area all back to do that. I like that. You know, it's like, I like hand jobs too. I
not
wish
all
every
of
bar.
Them are like that.
You
not
know who you
are. No, I know, but they, well, some of them, and they, the smart ones.
I'm with Tom on this. You can't go get a hand job at Bevo Brady's. I can watch the Braves. I can watch the Braves play, but I can't walk 7 feet to the side.
I thought that's why they called it Bevo Brady.
I wish. I'll see you at Beef's.
Bevo Gravy's.
This wouldn't work with the Crow, but let's say Daniel's at a Bevo Brady's, and they and then
I'm like, you gotta get down here. They're doing hand job night,
and then they have some stalls in the back to get a blowjob. I bet he could talk.
Well, I don't think so. She's in the chat room. Andrea, call in. Would you let me get a blowjob in a stall at Bevo Brady's?
No.
Yes or no?
Well, from her
would get a little.
Oh, from her.
Yeah,
I thought you meant from a man.
No,
so did I.
No.
I was on board. Now I don't want it.
If they had this,
would she do that though?
For heterosexual,
My wife would not do that
at a bar.
First of all, my wife hates sports bars. I can't even get her to go to Ale House.
You could go like Woodshed, right?
No, she's not an exhibitionist.
Yeah.
That's why straight women are boring.
She's in there. Yeah, I would not give him a hand job at Beef's. She said. That's a quote.
In a stall?
What if
they
had
a maze? If you walked through the maze and they had
an
umbrella.
An ache.
You know what? If you made it that stupid game, Two Dots, is that a game on the phone? What is it called? Five dots, three dots, two dots,
no
whatever.
Idea.
My wife and
you mean the password?
Or
to get
put
in,
it in her goddamn Duolingo. If you made it Duolingo, that she got a coupon for a month off of her Duolingo language translator. She'd do it.
Sounds like you need a dangling carrot to get
every
the
night. She's
touch.
Laying in her bed with her iPad with playing Two Dots and Duolingo. I'm like, put your device down.
That's why
give
gay
me
bars,
a handy.
Yeah, no, I can't say that.
That's why gay bars are better, because you're standing here drinking. Yeah. You're like, you know what? I want a hand job. And they're like, oh, umbrella. Go to the umbrella.
I'll give you one if you give me one. All right.
Well, this is everything I want. What else could you want?
That's why gay guys are getting meningitis right now.
It's a small price to pay.
It really
I don't
is.
Know what that is.
Meningitis. Girlingitis.
Yeah, like every gets that, it's fine. All right. You can touch your chin to your chest. Yeah,
if you're looking for a handy, you can go to Hanks or Barcodes.
There it is.
Or Club Orlando. Don't do it at Savoy. Don't do it at District Dive. You might be able to do it at Southern Night somewhere. Stonewall used to have the underwear night.
What's underwear night? Oh, we must have missed underwear night.
That's what the lockers are for. You'd go and you'd put all your clothes in the locker.
I know what the
lockers.
I saw
underwear.
The lockers.
But again, if I participated in that and I wasn't gay, I feel like
do you
I'm,
have to be? Sorry, I didn't mean to cut
do.
You off.
It'd
I'm
be
getting
no,
excited.
But if
do I have to look great, or can I be a little fudgy on underwear night?
No, all body types are.
Yeah, all body types.
You're not gonna. They're not. I'm not gonna get shamed. I'm gonna look around and see people like whispering because my gut flap's a little melty. No.
There's a whole scene for that.
Damn.
Oh,
otters, bears, cubs.
What am
chubs.
I? I'm a chubs. A cubs.
No, I like.
What
a,
am I?
You're a little bit of a bear.
I'm a baby bear.
A that's because of the beard.
I'm a baby bear.
A cub.
Yeah.
Is that what a cub is? A baby bear.
Well,
I want to be
yeah,
a baby
but
bear.
More fresh face.
I want to be referred to as a baby. Oh, he's a baby bear. Is that a thing, or can I make
there
that
you
up?
Go. You just self-identify.
I'm a baby bear. I identify as a baby
Tom's
bear.
A bit
I'm
of
a
an
baby
otter.
Bear in a diaper. I'm a little diaper baby.
I'm
a bear.
Faced,
in a...
You have to be hairier though.
Yeah. I'm not a real
you're
man.
You know what you are? You are a
jock.
You are a stressed out fairy. You are. I'm a baby bear.
I don't know why we have to be put into boxes. It's something I resist.
I
want to
put everybody in a box.
Everybody in a box. Yeah. Samantha.
With an umbrella on top.
Samantha is a paranoid lesbo. All right. You are.
All right, let's get out of here. Sam, what's semantics this weekend?
Yeah, we're recording tonight with Grifton Jess and our buddy Jesse from the Fourth and Dirty podcast.
All right.
Ooh. Those are both unpredictable guests. You never know what they will
Jess
drop.
Jess on Jess.
Yeah, that is a Jess on Jess scenario.
Brendan, you got anything going on coming up?
Nothing crazy. We're still pushing the Bungalow or Buddy keychain discounts. If you want to unlock Orlando with some really fun discounts, just head on over to bungalow.com/support us, and it gets you discounts at all types of places. Like Ravenous Pig, you could get happy hour prices any time of day, any day.
I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm. $25 burgers or $15 instead.
And they're really good burgers. Really good. Don't sleep on the Mahi sandwich. It's great. But I think you can only get it in the...
Don't bring up Mahi sandwiches around town.
You can only get it in the beer garden.
We give out soccer tickets all the time, too. And I think we're cooking something up for Orlando Pride. All right. A little box. So, yeah.
Very cool.
Tons of stuff for key members.
All right, guys. We got... I'll tell you a story that I can't tell on the AMT because I got to bury it in the BDM show. But it's about our fireworks display. But I don't want my neighbors to hear. So I'll tell that story on Monday.
Okay.
So if you're not a BDM, subscribe at TomandDan.com.
Yes.
And our BDM Beach Party is coming up in September.
Yep. We'll see you then, guys. Thanks so much. TomandDan.com for all things Tom and Dan. And
we'll see you next week.